हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11। द स्टोरी सल्वाटोर इज गोइंग ऑन नाउ डेज। यू प्लीज ओपन पेज नंबर 8, सेकेंड पैराग्राफ ऑफ द स्टोरी सल्वाटोर। हियर व्हेन सल्वाटोर वेंट होम ही फाउंड दैट दे ऑल न्यू his father, mother, and all the family members, his brothers, knew all about that girl. The girl's father had been to tell them what they had decided. They means here the parents of the girl. But they had lacked the courage to tell him themselves. They had no courage. The parents of Salvator had no courage to tell him about the incident, about the happenings, what happened, what did they say about Salvator. They hid the matter. He wept on his mother's bosom. He was terribly unhappy, but he did not blame the girl. This is the main his main quality, goodness. He did not blame the girl. A fisherman's life is hard, and it needs strength and endurance, patience. He knew very well that a girl could not afford to marry a man who might not be able to support her. He knew very well that a girl could not afford to marry a man who might not be able to support her life. His smile was very sad, and his eyes had the look of a dog that has been beaten. But he did not complain, and he never said a hard word of the girl he had loved so well. Students, this is the character of Salvatore. Then a few months later, when he had settled down, when he got a relief to the common round, working in his father's vineyard and fishing, his mother told him that there was a young woman in the village who was willing to marry him. Her name was Asanta. She is as ugly as the devil, he said. Salvatore knew her very well. He said that she is as ugly as the Satan, as the devil. She was older than he, the character of Asanta. She was older than Salvatore, 24 or 25, and she had been engaged to a man already, who, while during his military service, had been killed in Africa. She was a widow. She had a little money of her own, and if Salvatore married her, she could buy him a boat of his own with her own money, and they could take a vineyard that by happy chance happened at that moment to be without a tenant. His mother told him that Asanta had seen him at the festa, at the festival, and had fallen in love with him. सर्वाटो स्माइल्ड हिज स्वीट स्माइल एंड सेड ही वुड थिंक अबाउट इट। ही वुड मेकअप हिज माइंड टू मैरी सच टाइप ऑफ वूमेन। ऑन द फॉलोइंग संडे ड्रेस्ड इन द स्टिफ ब्लैक क्लॉथ्स इन विच ही लुक्ड सो मच लेस वेल देन इन द रैग्ड शर्ट बेटर देन दैट एंड ट्राउजर्स ऑफ एवरी डे ही वेंट अप टू हाई मास एट द पैरिश चर्च एंड प्लेस्ड हिमसेल्फ सो दैट ही कुड हैव अ गुड लुक एट द यंग वूमेन सो दैट ही कुड सी that young woman properly. When he came down again, he told his mother that he was willing. He gave his consent to marry Asanta. Well, they were married and they settled down in a tiny whitewashed house in the middle of a handsome vineyard. Salvatore was now a great, big, हस्की फेलो बिग एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग बिग हस्की फेलो स्ट्रॉन्ग टॉल एंड ब्रॉड बट स्टिल विद दैट इंजीनियस स्माइल चाइल्ड लाइक सिंप्लिसिटी बट स्टिल विद दैट इंजीनियस स्माइल चाइल्ड लाइक सिंप्लिसिटी लाइक चाइल्ड innocent smile and those trusting kindly eye shining gentle eyes that he had as a boy though his body became tall broad husky big but he was like a child kindly eyes that he had as a boy he was innocent he was still innocent he had the most beautiful manners I have ever seen in my life the narrator says here he had the most beautiful manners I have ever seen in my life Asanta was a grim visaged female gloomy nature serious grim visaged female with decided features and she looked old for her years for her age but she had a good heart and she was no fool I used to be amused by the little smile of devotion that she gave her husband when he was being very masculine manly and masterful sometimes when Salvatore showed his anger as he was her husband shows manly power and masterful he became masterful she never ceased to be touched by his gentle sweetness she never stopped to be touched by his gentle sweetness he was always gentle but she could not bear the girl who had thrown him over and notwithstanding Salvatore's smiling expostulations she had nothing but harsh word for her Salvatore had never any malice for that girl presently children were born to them it was a hard enough life all through the fishing season towards evening he set out in his boat with one of his brothers for the fishing grounds It was a long pull of 6 or 7 miles, and he spent the night catching the profitable cuttlefish. Then there was a long row back again in order to sell the catch in time for it to go on the early boat to Naples. He had go to sell the catch, sell the fish. It go on early boat to Naples. At other times he was working in his vineyard from dawn till the heat drove him to rest till noon, and then again when it was a trifle cooler till dusk. Trifle of no use. Till dusk. Morning till dusk. Often his rheumatism prevented him the illness. Rheumatism prevented him from doing anything at all. And then he would lie about the beach smoking cigarettes with a pleasant word for everything, everyone, notwithstanding the pain that racked his limbs. Though he suffered much for as he was suffering from rheumatism, but he did not care. The foreigners who came down to bathe and saw him there said that these Italian fishermen were lazy devils, because they did not see him when he worked hard. Sometimes he used to bring his children down to give them a bath. They were both boys, and at this time the elder was 3 and the younger less than 2. They sprawled about the water's edge, stark naked, and Salvatore standing on a rock would dip them in the water. The elder one bore it with stoicism. Sprawled means he had to sit with the limb open. Stoicism means emotional distress. The elder one bore it with emotional distress, but the baby screamed lustily, vigorously. Salvatore had enormous hands like legs of mutton, coarse and hard from constant toil. But when he bathed his children, he became very stout. His hands were very stiff, coarse, due to constant toil. But when he bathed his children, holding them so tenderly, so delicately, drying them with delicate care, upon my word, they were like flowers. He behaved with them like flowers, touched them, used to touch his children like flowers. He would seat the naked baby on the palm of his hand and hold him, laughing a little at his smallness. And his laugh was like the laughter of an angel. His eyes then were as candid, impartial as his child's. I started in the last paragraph, the author says, I started by saying that I wondered if I could do it, and now I must tell you what it is that I have tried to do. The writer says here, I wanted to see whether I could hold your attention for a few pages while I drew for you the portrait of a man. Just an ordinary fisherman who possessed nothing in the world except a quality which is the rarest. He had rarest qualities, the most precious and the loveliest that anyone can have. Heaven only knows why he should so strangely and unexpectedly have possessed it. This such type of rarest quality, how and why he had, only God knows. God knew. All I know is that it shone in him with a radiance, a warm light shining from something, that if it had not been unconscious and so humble, would have been to the common run of men, hardly bearable. If it had not been unconscious and so humble, would have been to the common run of men, hardly bearable. And in case you have not guessed what the quality was, I will tell you, goodness, just goodness. And by this way, the whole story is completed. My dear students, if you have any problem, you please ask me. Thank you so much.